guess it's because during the process, you keep making discoveries that you had no idea you knew. It just comes out while you're writing or while you're painting, and that gives you the feeling that when you keep on going, you can make more and more discoveries. And it's almost when you really get into it, it's almost like the work is telling you what to do.
And a thousand violins begin to play.
My name is Sharon Bourke. I'm 82 years old. I was born in Brooklyn, and I was raised in Bed-Stuy neighborhood in Brooklyn. I love doing art in school, and I like to express myself that way. In doing it, it felt like a trance, really. I used to like to take a big dark cloth and put it over a card table and then crawl in there and like make a house within my apartment, cut out pictures and tack them on all of the cloth that draped down. My family was not supportive of either my writing, what they didn't know about. Well, my mother knew about my paintings. She didn't like them. Yeah, I had a best friend, but I never shared my art with her. We used to listen to music a lot. Sometimes we cut classes, go to the Apollo. It was mostly for me a private space, my own work. When I did art or when I wrote, that was pretty much a loner's kind of pursuit. I don't think of leaving a legacy because I've had very little success. And I keep on doing it anyway. I do it for me. Paintings themselves, they keep on teaching me new things. And I keep on going. I like structure. I like, when you tie a shoe or a boot and you come all the crisscrosses and there's a combination at the top. I love that process and that structure. And it's the same to me as being in a cathedral and seeing the archways. I get the same good feeling. Art makes people happy, usually, or gives them solace anyway. Thousands of people on July 4th go out and see fireworks. And what is that? What is that? Some lights and shapes and a bit of music. But they want to do that. It nourishes them. And that's what I think that the creativity does. Either to make it or to enjoy it or to take it in.